Well, hello, my ghouls and goblins.
Hi, Brainiacs. Welcome to the video store. So before we start with the review, please take time to subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so you're not gonna miss any cool video that's coming up about movies and video games, and welcome to any newcomers on the channel. Adam Sandler, Netflix Halloween comedy special. Great movie or not? Depends on what you're looking for. I generally like Adam Sandler's old comedies. A lot of them are disposable though. You watch them once, forget them like a bad hookup. I mean, for one Big Daddy, you get to Jack and Jill. For one Uncut Gem, really love that drama by the way, you get a Hubie Halloween. Don't get me wrong, this guy can still be funny. Really like his Netflix stand-up comedy special 100% Fresh. Especially two of its songs that will stick in your ears for days on end. First one, Phone Wallet Keys. It's true too, cause when I'm heading out, all I need to take with me are my phone wallet keys.
Phone wallet keys, yeah.
Yeah, phone wallet keys. Phone, phone, phone. And as a big MMA fan, second song, he's right. A lot of MMA fighters have UFC ears.
UFC ears, UFC ears.
And when it comes to the actual person, you want to root for Adam. Seems like a genuine, down-to-earth person. Hubie Halloween story is about Hubie, the town loser. This guy gets bullied by anybody who can walk or who can talk. It is Hubie against the world. On Halloween night, he'll be tested by the forces of evil who takes over the town of Salem. Who or what is murdering people around town? Will Hubie get the hot girl? Will Hubie be accepted as who he really is? As much as it sounds thrilling and enticing, is it? If you have a lazy rainy afternoon to spare, I dare you to find out. We'll start with the good parts. It got the Halloween feels right from the visuals, to the music, the costumes, and the sound effects. And this is a big part of why people will come to this movie. A lot of cool cameos too, one of them in particular. The usual suspects are involved. Adam Sandler's regulars like Steve Buscemi, Rob Schneider, Kevin James, or newcomers like Ray Liotta. They all seem to have a very good time here. This movie does not take itself seriously either, and that's what you should expect from a Sandler comedy. For all these reasons, for the first 40 minutes, I was a bit engaged, and then, the further that the plot progressed, my attention started to drift away. Now for the things I did not like that much about that movie. Adam Sandler's characters in Hubie is kinda like Bobby Boucher in Waterboy.
Oh, I love my mama very much. Now you know that.
And I love Waterboy. He's a simple-minded boy who talks with a weird, muted voice.
Supermarket selling expired bacon. Janet at the library has not been herself lately. I heard a voice in the sewer.
I'm sorry, I didn't recognize.
I know that a lot of viewers dislike Hubie's voice. I did not really mind it. But when it comes to what you should expect from this character, it's very shallow. His multi-versatile Inspector Gadget thermos is one big part of his personality. Yeah, that says a lot.
Kind of like a Swiss Army thermos. I made it when I was in the scouts.
He's a kind soul, but he's always bullied. And the first scene when you met him, riding his bike, he releases a geyser of vomit. This introduction to the character tells you everything you need to know about him.
Rocky Balboa style.
For the story, it's a little all over the place. Then again, for this type of comedy, I'm not expecting a masterpiece when it comes to story development. Though I think that movies like, let's say, Joe Dirt, which is in the same vein as Adam Sandler's movies, can showcase a more compelling and coherent story. I think that the narration in Hubie Halloween gets worse with each exposition dump. Aside from that, filler characters are awkwardly introduced, especially the main kids. They're more instrumental to the story than fleshed out characters. Predictable ending, generally speaking, no surprise there. The general tone is also a bit off. It's as if this movie is targeted towards kids, but also targeted towards adults. For example, and it's one of my favorite parts of the movie, one character wears the best t-shirts, totally unaware that they're all about sexual innuendos. Boner donor? No thank you. So what did other online critics say about the movie? As always, the scores can change over time. On Rotten Tomatoes, 50% from critics and 49% from 815 users. On IMDb, 5.2 out of 10 from 17,904 users. On Metacritic, 53% from 19 critics and 5.2 out of 10 from 65 users. On Google, 3.9 out of 5 out of 3,029 users critics. Here are a few critics which represent the overall consensus for this movie. None of this is particularly original, but nobody said you had to be original to make people laugh. Unexpectedly is generally bearable, a light, sweet, and nostalgic comedy that is pleasantly devoid of high stakes. Sandler has always been a repository of goofy voices, but what he thought was funny about the mannered neutering he does here is unclear. Sandler's laugh-free special will end in your living room like a flaming paper bag. I think you'll like this movie if you like Adam Sandler's movies, the good ones and the bad ones. If you're a kid, if you like Halloween movies. On the other end, you're not gonna like this movie if you don't like Adam Sandler's movies, especially the bad ones. If you don't like Halloween movies, and maybe if you're an adult as well.
Let's talk.
Did you like Hubie Halloween? What is your best Adam Sandler movie? Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel to see more cool videos like the latest The Boys Season 1 and Season 2 review and the Doctor Sleep review. Until next time, Brainiacs, keep on Netflix and bone chilling.
This is some Dateline NBC shit.